then it really showed you up front, right, later in the movie, what really happened.
Or did it? As I'm walking out my second time viewing the movie with a friend, and we did the same thing, he immediately turned to me and he said, so this meant this and that meant that,
right,
and I
right.
started to explain it to him, and then I suddenly said, you know, what if the whole thing was a delusion? What if we're seeing the whole thing from his perspective? None of it happened, or none of it happened the way we saw it. And then the narrative became...
Now we're in The Matrix. That's another movie we'll have to refer to.
Well, and maybe I'm referencing that too. But I think part of that is I've just read this book on neuro-linguistic programming.
Oh, there you
and
go.
So,
NLP, here we go.
You know, the guy that wrote it, his tact is generally about how we all have perceptual filters, right?
Right. Oh.
So I'm communicating with you right now, but you're bringing an entire backstory, an entire history, an entire genetic makeup, on and on and on.
Yes.
So what you're hearing may not be what I'm intending you to hear.
Well, that is very true.
So when I came out of the movie,
shout
I was
sort of... Shout out to Gottman right there, but go ahead.
Right. I come out of the movie and I'm like... The whole NLP thing I'm reading is
okay.
Sort of explodes over me, and then my brother, you know, it's 10 o'clock, I got to go home, but you know, right. My brother's like, can't we go have a coffee and you know,
you drop this
grenade, but anyway,
but yeah, so it could have been out the whole thing, but I think here's the, I guess this is movie producer doing this for helping the audience. By showing him scenes with him and the girl out on the street together, mm-hmm. and then showing a scene where he's standing there by himself and there's no one around.
Right.
Him. So he is, that's the clue. And it did that about three, maybe four times. Quick scenes.
The
right
usual suspects
end.
Approach.
Right.
You get to see what really happened.
You finally get to see that there was no one there when he was doing all these little things and eating at restaurant and all that kind of stuff. So from my point of view, and I may be wrong, but the idea that the director wanted us to know, wait a minute, this guy's not just, you know, kind of a killer type.
Yeah.
He's also delusional, and he's made up this relationship to sort of comfort himself. And there may be something very important in that. And this is another Dan Rose reference where he was doing a bad job the best he could, I think. Wait, okay, I'll leave it at that. It was he's settled with a bad job and he's doing the best he can. And that means he is doing that delusional imaginary character and scenes that kind of play out. But then at the end, he shows up in her apartment. This is all the time when those two scenes were going on back and forth with him and without it. He shows up after some murders in her apartment.
Yeah.
And that seemed to be
and
the real.
And he's a dark dude, too. He's really in a dark place.
In a dark place. She is totally scared. Who are you? What are you doing in my apartment? Which I found kind of, okay, that helped me understand, wait a minute, this guy's really delusional. He's out there making up everything.
The movie sets you up to ask those questions, though. Even I get what you're saying about the director sort of leads you in that direction.
Yeah, kind of gives us. But then, I mean, I hear your take on it, too, just to get back before you say this.
You know where I'm going.
I know it's coming. I know it's coming. So that basically that could have been just a red herring sort of thing, too, and left us, did he really not? I mean, you know, those. So it gives us a choice of deciding whether that's delusion or not. I've kind of thought, well, okay, with all this other stuff going on for this guy, he's making up, characters to live his life with him or not.